Okay. The police do crazy things. We know that. We've reported on that here at Indisputable. This particular police officer, according to the investigation, responded to a 911 call that was a mental health emergency. He went to the home and he decided to masturbate in the home. Let's put up his picture. This is San Jose police officer Matthew Dominguez. He's the officer accused of doing this insane thing. The police chief wanted to walk him out of the precinct personally. Here's the video of the chief walking out this cop. Let me give you some background to this story. A San Jose police officer has been arrested for allegedly masturbating inside a home where officers were responding to a call, one of the latest instances of misconduct among San Jose PD. I got a few things to highlight here. Officer Matthew Dominguez, 32 years of age, faces a misdemeanor indecent exposure charge. Santa Clara County DA Jeff Rosen said if convicted, he could face a year in jail and be placed on the sexual offender list for 10 years. The charged behavior is beyond disturbing, said the DA in a prepared statement. Law enforcement officers respond to our homes to help crime victims, not terrorize, traumatize, and create new victims. The way this happened is so unreal that you would assume this came from some kind of perverted satire site. But this is actually a real story with an actual investigation and corroborating witnesses. The alleged incident happened on April 21st. According to the DA's office, Dominguez, the cop, and two other officers had responded to a home on a call that a mentally ill family member was being violent. Dominguez sent the other officers away. So he sent them away to locate the subject and shortly after touched himself in front of two female family members, the DA's office said. Now understand how depraved his mind is. He's responding to a call of an actual crisis, a mental health crisis, an individual needs attention. This is when you shine as a public servant. You provide remedy to the situation, you provide help. He has a plan already. So this officer, according to the report, decided to send the other two cops away so he could masturbate inside of this home in front of the two women there. There's more. Afterward, Officer Dominguez allegedly exposed himself to the mother, and the victims then reported his behavior to two other male relatives nearby, one of whom witnessed part of the incident. The allegations are the latest against a member of the San Jose Police Department. We've actually covered this not too long ago. Most recently, an officer was placed on leave for being drunk on the job while at the baby Brandon kidnapping scene. We covered that. While rookie officer Dejon Packer, who died in March, was determined to have died because of fentanyl substance abuse. We covered that too. Now I want to say this, okay? Obviously, this is not the first time Dominguez has done something like this. It is not. He did not all of a sudden decide, hey, this is a good opportunity for me to start masturbating in front of people that actually need 911 services, emergency help. Now, what was going through his mind at the time, I don't know, but I highly doubt this was his first time doing such an egregious thing. So you have this guy, you have another individual who was drunk doing an investigation of a missing baby. You have another person who died of a fentanyl overdose and had other chemicals in his system, another cop, all right? And the list goes on and on. Now, some people will say, well, mine, that is a problematic police department. No, it's a problematic police culture. You see, we keep calling it the criminal justice system. And after review, I have decided it's not actually a criminal justice system, because these systems really are not connected. One police agency has no bearing over another. What happens in Atlanta really doesn't have much bearing over what happens in LA. These systems are disjointed, as we call it. So they're not systems in the traditional sense. We call them systems to explain the narrative. But it's more of a culture. It is a criminal justice culture. And for some reason, it seems as if this criminal justice culture attracts a certain type of individual. Now, of course, there are exceptions to this rule, but you cannot dismiss the fact that over 40% of those who are currently in uniform have admitted to some level of physical violence against someone they love inside of their home. That is a problem. There's more. Also on Thursday, the San Jose police and the mayor confirmed another police officer was placed on leave months ago after allegedly giving a woman a methamphetamine pipe in exchange for information. Officer Dominguez was a 4-year veteran of the department, is currently on administrative leave from the police department. On Thursday, San Jose Chief Anthony Mata walked Dominguez out. You saw that in the video. This was after his internal affairs interview, shortly after the DA's office decided to file the charge. Now, let me tell you why the fix is already in. And if you follow this show, you already know what I'm about to say. I've noticed something in the charging docket. If they don't charge the officer with violation of oath of office, they're playing games. This is a violation of Dominguez's actual oath. When you see a DA charge them with a misdemeanor, and they decide not to charge them with the felony version of whatever the offense is, nor do they place the charge of actual violation of oath, the fix is in. They're being easy on the individual. This person will receive no jail time. There will be very little penalty. And once again, he will be able to move on to another jurisdiction and possibly terrorize somebody else. Mata's action to escort the officer out is a follow-up on a public declaration the chief made during a news conference last week to address instances of officer misconduct. The chief said in a statement that read, "Last week I said that when an officer violated the public's trust or engages in criminal conduct, I would personally walk that officer out of the door. Today I did it." Oh, that's the solution. The solution here, chief, is that you're going to ignore the culture of corruption you have at your police department, and you're simply going to walk them out the front door personally. That changes nothing. That doesn't change anything. The issues that you have are systemic. They're indoctrinated. They're ingrained into the cultural reality of that police department. What are you doing to investigate? I heard no mention of you investigating this officer to see who else he has victimized while in uniform. I heard no investigation being opened into the previous cop who was drunk during an investigation to look at other cases he may have effed up. Or what about the one who OD'd on fentanyl? Did you look at his record to open up investigations into arrest or maybe even patterns of other misconduct? No. But I mean, chief, you are walking people out the front door though. And you get to go on camera and look good and seem really statesmanlike without changing a damn thing at your department. Dan, thoughts here?
I also do appreciate in that video that the police chief, Anthony Mata, opened the door for the guy. He didn't let the guy who was just accused of masturbating on the scene to touch the door. That's at least COVID-19 protocols. I'm happy to see
right,
that.
I agree.
No, but ultimately, you're so right about this. Not only is this a performative measure from Chief Anthony Mata, who gets to post this nice video saying, "I'm personally walking these abusive cops out the door." That's literally all you can do, because even he admitted in a press conference that there are really strong police unions that essentially limit how quickly he can fire a cop. And so we've seen how this game plays before, just like Dr. Rashad Richey just explained. There's gonna be administrative leave, it's gonna go through this fake investigation, if there's even an investigation at all. There will be no change in the police culture because this won't be put into the larger pattern of why we constantly see police abuse their positions of power day in and day out, even in cases that aren't reported, that aren't as brazen and almost comical if it weren't so sadistic as this case. But all these cases are all taken in isolation. There's never, rarely if ever, any justice done. And yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if you see the same officer just transferred to another department in another state or even another county, or maybe even just rehired later on, because this is just the way things go. And San Jose especially has much more cleaning up to do, and these videos aren't doing it.
Yeah, and just a reminder, misdemeanor convictions do not eliminate an officer from receiving post certification, which allows them to have arrest powers.